Okay, this one is point number one. This one is point number two. Number one thing, you can take reference anywhere as you wish. So from this point, you have to measure Z1. This one is Z2. So in simple language is Z1 and Z2. Point number one, open to atmosphere. Point number two, open to atmosphere. Tank size is not given to you. So it is very, very large. So V1 is zero. Ab is baat ke upar dhyan rakhna padega aapko. Kyunki ek problem udhar aaya na is karan. And this diameter has to give and we have to calculate this one. So my term is like this. P1 upon rho g, is it zero? V1 square upon 2g, is it zero? Z1 equal to Z1. Z1 equal to Z1. Left hand side is finished. Right hand side. P2 by rho g, zero. V2 square by 2g exist. Velocity rahega yahan par. Is a Z2 exist? So we have a same original story. Is it V2 equal to under root of 2 times? And is Z1 minus Z2 is nothing but the total vertical height available from point number 1 to 2. So actually we are not interested where is, what is Z1 and what is Z2. What we are interested is the vertical difference between these two points. So this value is equal to what? I will say capital H. For us it is capital H always. Meters of column. So our equation is that value. He will give any value. We should not confuse about that one. He will say that this value, that is this value equal to Z3, this value equal to Z4. He will try to confuse you to read this problem. But you must be very clear that what is the height between 1 and 2. That matters. Bahut confuse karke rakhega aapko. Wo bolega ye Z3 hai, ye value Z4 hai. Fir bolega ki ye distance mera itna hai. आपको ऐसे कोई डाटा के ऊपर ध्यान देना नहीं है. यू हैव टू ओनली कॉन्सेंट्रेट पॉइंट नंबर वन एंड पॉइंट नंबर टू एंड हाउ यू कैन ऑब्टेन एच. फॉर दैट व्हाट डाटा यू रिक्वायर यू अरेंज दैट डाटा. पॉइंट नंबर वन क्लियर. देन एट दिस पॉइंट नंबर थ्री फर्स्ट यू चेक फ्रॉम वन टू थ्री वी आर नॉट यूजिंग एनी मशीन बट द फ्लूइड इज स्टिल लिफ्टेड. इट मीन्स दैट देयर मस्ट बी अ सक्शन. सो वी कैन अप्लाई बर्नौली आइदर बिटवीन वन एंड थ्री और आइदर बिटवीन थ्री एंड टू. एनी चॉइस यू कैन टेक. Advantage of this point is that P1 is 0, V1 is 0. So it will solve very fast. Second thing is that what is the velocity here? Is it the same velocity here also? So this velocity is V2 is same as V3. So I am applying Bernoulli between 1 and 3. P1 by rho g 0. P1 by rho g 0. V1 square by 2g 0. I have to say this height. Let's say this height equal to what? Z. This one is Z. So with reference to this point, 2 is at high right. So Z1 will be assigned 0. So P1 by rho g 0, V1 square by 2g 0, Z1 is 0. So we don't have any height, no energy at point number 1. But you have a energy here equals to P3 by rho g exists because it is a closed conduit now. V3 is same as V2 by 2g and is a value of Z. This value is Z3 from this point. I will only say Z because this one is taken as datum now. So this is Z. If you solve this one, you will get P3 value as negative value. Both these terms will shift to the left hand side. So it is confirmed that P3 is always negative. Means it is a suction. So whenever you draw petrol from friend's tank, the suction is created here. But remember, first you have to make the suction here. And once the flow will start, you can maintain it. But it doesn't mean that you can take this tank like this also. Because the suction is always limited. Revisit your study. Is it atmospheric pressure? Is a complete vacuum. Complete vacuum and atmospheric pressure is the limiting value is 1.013 bar. This one is atmospheric. This is complete vacuum. This maximum value permitted is minus 1.013 to 10 to the power 5 Pascal. If this one is water, then must equal to rho gh. Rho is 1000, g is 9.81. So maximum suction we can have is h is equal to minus 10.32. I have given you this value. So you cannot make the height between this point and this point more than 10.32 meters. If you try to make, the flow will stop. So this is natural maximum, this is maximum suction possible. Huh? That is why limitation. But if you have a pump here and you want to deliver, you can deliver any height. A siphon tube having a diameter of 2 cm draws water from a large open reservoir and discharges into a open atmosphere as shown in the figure. Assuming incompressible flow, you have to find out the two things, velocity and volumetric flow rate. So we'll consider here point number 1. Let's say outside this one we have point number 2. This height is Z1 minus Z2.
that is equal to 5 meters. So we have V2 equals to under root of 2 times G Z1 minus Z2. So simply substitute the value, we will get under root of 2 into 5, and this answer is 9.9 meter per second. So our choice A is correct. To find out the volumetric flow rate, we'll use the Q equal to A2 into V2. Pi by 4 into diameter of the tube is 2 cm is 0.02 square. Velocity is 9.9. So this one is 3.11 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube per second. 10 to the power 3 liter per second. So this answer is 3.11. So choice A is correct choice. This is second example on the siphon again. We are given the figure and we are given two heights. We have to find out the velocity. For this one, we will consider two points. Point number 1 open to atmosphere. So this net height will be equals to H2 minus H1. So Z1 minus Z2 is same as H2 minus H1. So your equation number C is correct, because velocity is given by under root of 2 times G H2 minus H1. Choice C is correct choice. This problem was solved by Bernoulli equation. So we will consider here one point. This velocity is equal to V2. This point equal to one point open to the atmosphere. And we'll take here one point just outside is 2. And we can apply the Bernoulli equation now. So this will take as datum, which is my lowest point in the figure. Capital H is same as my Z1. So I can find out my Z2, which is equals to capital H minus small h. So we have a standard Bernoulli equation. Our point number 1 is equal to 0, because point number 1 is open to atmosphere. Size of tank is not given, so assume very large tank. So velocity equal to 0. Z1 equal to capital H. V2 equals to 0, open to atmosphere. V2 exists, V2 square by 2G, and Z2 is capital H minus small h. So in this case, our capital H will get cancelled on both sides. So that is why velocity V2 is simply equal to under root of 2GH.